across all across the hip. And another thing we can look and we'll start to see too, you start to see after you've been limping on that extremity for 5+ years, right? Yeah. You can even see you got a little bit of restriction in the way your ankle, where your toes come to your nose. And again, if we're thinking surfing and we want to get your pop up, you want to get down, when you're down that low position, you want to have that flexibility in your ankle. And that, you know, you're not using your hip, your ankle, everything kind of trudges along. So that's something else we can start to focus on. When we switch to the other side, you're actually benefiting from the ankle up into the hip. Because if your ankle is going to be restricted, it's going to put pressure on your knee, hip, almost all the way up the chain to your shoulder.
So exactly. Now we're going to do the exact same on the opposite side?
Yep. So do the same thing on the opposite side.
Symmetry is very important. So you want to make
now, if we had a mirror or something that you could stand and look into, that would be a great feedback tool for you.
Yeah, dropping straight down is easier on this leg.
Big words to think about are the kinetic chain, your body going from your foot all the way up through your knee, hip, spine, neck, and head, are all one chain of synchronous movement. And the chain is only as strong as its weakest link. So you want to make sure all the links are of equivalent functional strength. You're training proprioception, which is a series of different terms. One is kinesthesia, which is the body's ability to sense movement, and joints' ability to sense its position and space and time. And that's why the Indo Board is a good functional rehabilitation tool, is because it allows dynamic, real-time joint position gauging.
I like that. And then one of the things we'll see, and we can add on a little bit, is, as we talked in the beginning, you're going to have strengths and weaknesses in the front part of your hip, back part of your hip, and the outside part of your hip. And especially when one limps for a while, you start to get weird compensations where you'll start to get a little bit drop hip because you're not using it. It's really common that the way your body works is a muscle over here, your gluteus medius, that when I stand on my left leg, this muscle actually pulls down like a lever and keeps my hip from dropping. Same thing over here. But if you're limping on this leg, every time you're limping here, this muscle's not working as much, and you can actually get an effect the other side. You see a lot of people post-surgical, their opposite hip, downrange, start to get some issues because this muscle wasn't, because you're not working, because you're gimping through it versus walking through. So that's where you'll see a lot of the stuff when you work, especially using a balance device, using an Indo Board, those muscles, when you're making those hip adjustments, are going to be working those balancing muscles to keep your hips nice and level. So when you look in the mirror and you look at the belt, you're not dropping to one side or the other. And someone who's had hip issues, that's almost like, why am I getting this bursitis, this itis in my hip? Because everything's strong, I got all this stuff, but these secondary issues come up. So that's something you want to always start off in the beginning, is make sure your attention to detail for those small things that add up cumulatively down the range. What we're going to do with Hunter is we're going to work a little bit on some hip stability while we're doing an activity. So what we want to try to have him do is to focus on strengthening on one hip, but yet on the other side of his body, he's going to be doing, I hate to say distraction, but an activity that his mind has to do two things at once, because we don't want to get so focused, tense, that we're just strength on the affected hip without having his brain doing something else. Because in our everyday life, we always have to multitask, and we want the body to learn how to do a little bit of a multitask. Good leg first, so we're going to step with your left leg here and your affected hip on the forearms, because this is going to fatigue out pretty quick, so I want to make sure that you have a good comfort level.
So back foot.
Back foot, almost, you can go a little bit forward, so in the center of the board. We're going to get him down into like a semi-squatting position. Almost, you want to think about a speed skater, downhill skier, or again, going into surfing, someone who's just dropped in and they're ready to drop in down into a wave.
Okay, head and shoulders.
Hold up, look, we're going to be looking
straight
spine, looking down at the beach.
Yep.
You're ready to drop down and carve at the bottom of the wave. And then we're having him moving his left foot fore and aft. Again, he's getting a little bit of glide in his ankle. We're doing a little range of motion of his ankle and his knee. That outside hip, we're talking about the stability of those gluteus minimus and medius. That lateral stabilizer is going to start working pretty good. He should feel good, a little burn in the outside part of his hip. You'll notice his posture is really good. He's flat, square at the shoulder, square at the hip. Breathing's always important when we're doing exercise, so think about breathing. Not as much panting, but think about breathing through the belly.
And I'm praying that this works.
Works, exactly. He wants to get a little easier, too. He can take his hands up and reach up overhead, make it a little more challenging. The hip, again, we'll keep emphasizing, we want to make sure we balance things out, because that his good hip has had to work pretty hard over the last couple years as he's experienced pain and dysfunction, and it may be overused, underused, but we want to create balance, so when he's ready to go hard charging again, both sides of his body are functioning the same, and they're talking the same language to one side or the other. And one hip's not doing one thing and the other is doing the other.
Right, so the goal is to get back on my twin fin.
Okay.
My little 6'2".
So right now I'm able to surf on my longboard, but I'm having a little difficulty getting to my feet. So this is what we're addressing, all right?
So here we're going to lunge down again. Try to drop straight down like we did in that first exercise. Trying to keep your heel on the ground on that side. Very good. And then working that hip here. This one you'll probably fatigue out a little faster than it did on the other side, just because of what's going on in that hip. So what I want you to think about now is keeping that same position, grabbing these muscles, take your shoulder blades, squeeze down into your hip, very good. Bear down your abdominal muscles there, very good. Now keep that up. Recruit, use these other parts of your body to help support you when you start to feel fatigue. A lot of times, think of when you fatigue, what's the first thing you start to do? Your shoulders get up to your ears, you hunch over, and you have trouble breathing or anything?
Give up posture.
You give up posture. So you really want to think about those muscles by your ribs, your serratus, those muscles down here in your low back. Taking the shoulder blades, screw them down, pretending you're holding a pencil on your spine between your shoulder blades. Very good.